bizarre ending there. I mean, what do you make of completing the sweep in that fashion?
Well, I would have preferred for Scarlett to finish her bat. I'm serious. She was in the zone, and she fouled three or four off, and all it would have taken was a base hit. You know, I feel sorry for Georgia with that ending that way because they fought hard and played hard. But that's the rule. You know, we did manage to get a girl on second and a girl on third, so it was very obvious an illegal pitch. She fell with the ball still in her hand, and I feel sorry for her too, but that's the rules, and that's the way it goes.
Have you ever seen anything like that?
Never. Never. I've been coaching a lot of years and never seen anything like that.
I mean, it was a really bizarre ending, but you completed a three-game sweep of the top 10 team. So despite how it happens, I'm guessing you're still happy that you...
Oh, yeah. I'm happy. Yeah, I'm happy. Like I said, I would have liked to have had a base hit in that last at-bat, and now we'll never know, you know. But I think we were putting pressure on every inning, and the fact that we had eight hits and they had one, that our pitchers held the best hitting team in the conference coming in, second best hitting team in the conference coming in to one run, one hit, or no runs, one hit, I think is a positive.
Was there just something really different about the way Tarango and Gaffin pitched tonight? Because they just, it seemed, struggled maybe to adjust whenever Gaffin came in.
No, they're getting better. They're getting better every outing. Just remember, Tarango first threw about a week and a half ago because she was injured the first 20-plus games of the season. And I thought she threw really well because I think the rest of the country and conference thinks Georgia's a good team. Georgia's a very strong team. So it was a good battle. It was a different kind of battle. We're not used to being in those kind of battles. Both teams are used to hitting the ball, but, you know, Gray pitched a pretty good game too. I haven't looked at the film, but she never let us score. She closed the door every opportunity we had.
And I guess being at 3-3 coming into this weekend, I mean, you guys obviously now 6-3. That sounds a whole lot better. Do you feel like this weekend kind of puts you guys in better shape as you head towards the meat of the conference schedule?
Well, again, I think every coach in this conference will tell you every win you get during this season puts you in better shape. I saw a commercial for the SEC where the Mississippi State coach said that if you play eight series in the SEC, it's like playing eight super regionals. And I really feel the same way. I'm drained. My team's drained every time we play like this, but I think that's why the SEC is getting so strong in postseason. You go through that week after week after week, you know, and I'm sure Georgia's feeling tired too. You know, I mean, it was a battle.
You mentioned this game was a battle that you're not used to playing these kind of games. Is this a good game for you to play moving forward in the season?
Oh, absolutely. You know, absolutely. Anytime you play, anytime you're fortunate enough to beat a team that's ranked ahead of you, you know, it's a good thing, okay? And, you know, I'm proud of our kids. I'm really proud of our kids. I'm proud of the way they fought. But like I said, we played a good team, too, a well-coached team, the whole three games.
Just out of curiosity, what do you want CJ to do in that situation? Do you want her to stay on the bag until the umpire says absolutely go on home? Or?
Well, the umpire, I don't know if you saw it, but the umpire waved her home. Uh-huh. The third base umpire, yes, I want her to stay on the bag until the umpire waves her home, but he did wave her home. Once they put their arm out like that and signal illegal pitch, that's the rule. The runners advance one base.
And did you have any thought when, I guess, their coach came out to kind of have a word and their players kind of stayed on the infield for a second? Did you thought ever cross your mind that, hey, maybe they're going to have a conference about this? Or?
No, because like the umpire said to their coach, she never let go of the ball. You know, she never let go of the ball. So either way, I'm not an umpire. You know, I don't umpire it. We waited there. We were polite. We waited till the argument finished, and that's what we needed to do.
Was that one of the most, like, reluctant celebrations you've ever experienced as a coach after the win? I mean...
Yeah, it was, because, number one, I was really happy to win. But number two, I felt for Georgia, you know. And again, I'm not saying that as not being a competitor. I just felt like, you know, the game was close. We were fighting back and forth. Both teams were giving it everything. And, you know, it ends on an illegal pitch. A legal, illegal pitch. But, you know, whatever. I thought we were going to get the hit anyhow.
So if she just lets that ball go, even if she kind of stumbles to the ground after she lets it go, is it going to be a pitch, even if it just kind of wobbles?
Or? You'll have to ask an umpire on that. I'm not going to start answering rule questions. If I do, I'll be wrong.
What contributed to such a strong finish near the end of the game?
For us, Well, actually, you know, I didn't think it was such a strong finish. I mean, I know we were threatening, but we had the opportunity to put it away about five times. We had runners in scoring position. First time we didn't get the bunt down. Second time there was an overthrow and we should have been on second. The next ground ball would have moved us to third and the deep fly ball would have won it for us. You know, we were playing freshman softball a lot of times in the late innings. And like I said, if you go back through the game, you're going to see that Tennessee had a lot of chances to win it. And we just, we weren't playing heads up softball late innings.